Yeah, I'm in the hot seat, Oscar.
Good. There's another shipment coming in by plane. The drop site is over near the Sonora National Park. Local runners got a good grip on that area, so watch your back.
You got it. I've made the pickup. Persistent fuckers, aren't you?
Control.
You want the good news or the bad news?
How bad can it be?
Those hillbilly local runners, they've moved in on your airfield and are using it as a base.
What? I will fucking destroy them!
I thought you'd say that. So the good news is, my guys fitted the plane with a new carpet bombing system. Instead of a single bomb, you can now drop a chain. Just make sure you have several targets lined up beneath the plane before releasing, so we don't waste ammo.
Oh, I won't waste any.
All of them? Great, man!
Done.
Use it to my ears. your last target, so come on back to the airfield.
If only we spend as much time trafficking as we do bombing traffickers.
Hey, I thought that was capitalism, my friend. 10% business, 90% putting other people out of business.
How many of these fuckers are there? Never had to work so hard for a monopoly in my life.
Son ratos, hermano. They're always multiplying.
What? You ever get the feeling we might be understaffed? Me, you, and an antique airplane.
That's called efficiency, Trevor.
That's called something, man. Want a lobotomy. Idiot!
Thank you. to throwing feces at the pandas. Jimbo, you take the fashion show. Use the
You better not fucking go near
there.
Me, fool.
Jorge, you graffiti the country club. Something original this time. Danny, Orville, I need you.
Hands where I can see him, boyfriend.
Stay back. You're not taking me in.
From me. All right, stop. I'll come quietly.
Correct decision. Come on, road trip. Sit your ass down in here! You gonna play nice now, Granddad?
I'd rather die fighting than surrender to the hypocritical laws of your oppressive regime.
Although you did, in fact, surrender.
I took a stance, didn't I? Stared the bully in the face, then backed down at the last minute. That's how activism works. Not that I'd expect a mindless drone of a nanny state like you to understand.
Whatever. You know, I never realized hobos were so well armed.
I'm not a hobo. I've made a conscious decision to reject the capitalist society.
By living in a hobo camp.
It's a lifestyle choice, you government stooge. And have you looked in the mirror recently? This discrimination disgusts me. I only just got out of jail for that sit-in protest outside the Exchange in Liberty City. Such a sense of the power of group action until we all turned on each other.
What are they trying to send you down for now? I didn't pay much attention to your file.
Of course you didn't. I assaulted a cop at an anti-globalization rally, beat him up with a fire extinguisher, and I'd do it again. Screw the police. Nothing but mindless stoolies of the totalitarian regime.
You're preaching to the choir, Pops.
What? You're worse than they are. A paid thug of a corrupt legal system rounding up agitators for the ruling autocracy? A puppet on a power trip. I just wonder who's got their hand up your ass.
Whoa! Hold on there, socialist Santa. If you want an anarchy off, I will take you down any day. I wreak indiscriminate mayhem on an hourly basis. And secondly, no one has a hand up my ass. Would you like to look? Listen, nobody's more anti-establishment than me, old man. I hate authority, so watch your tone.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hired mensch of the dictatorship. Did Daddy not love you?
No. Daddy left me at a shopping mall and never came back, so I burnt it to the ground! I've lost count of the number of people I've killed in just the last week, and I am very happy to add your name to the pile right now! So why don't you shut your mouth?
Okay, we'll leave it there. Touchy subject, I see. Are you getting some perverse satisfaction out of dragging this out?
Well, if it isn't my dear old buddy Trevor, and he's brought me this reprobate.
Hello, Maud.
You know, I kind of look upon you as the friend I never had, the son I never wanted, and the shrink I could never afford.
You do?
Kinda. The pursuit of criminal men for profit is back-breaking, soul-crushing work.
Oh, I can only imagine.
I'm retiring, Trevor. I want a peaceful life away from all this insanity and degradation. I want a picket fence, and a husband, and a dog named Skip. I want the dream, Trevor, and I won't let anyone stand in my way.
Good for you, Maud. I wish you well on that quest.
I'll find it, Trevor. I'll find it all. I'm a passionate woman. Goodbye, my boy.
Goodbye, Maud. Be well. Sakes.
Got another pickup for you near the old dock house. I got a bad feeling the Aztecas know about this, so watch yourself.
Competition's been eliminated. Phillips style.
Nice work.
Thank you.
got more buyers lined up. Coordinates for the drop sites should be up on screen any second now.
Cargo received.
Money in the bank, man.
Package right on target.
That's what I like to hear.
The drop.
That means all the buyers have their deliveries? Nice work. Bring the plane back in.
There you are, Trevor.
Oh, but ain't my favorite marksman, huh? How are you, Cletus?
Fine and dandy, sir. You ready to hunt some elk?
Beat satellite dishes. Lead the way.
Oh, here you go. Now, put this in your mouth. A bad day hunting still beats a good day working, my pa always used to say.
What is this thing in my mouth? And why do I have the feeling I'm not the first person to use it?
I'll explain that in a while. Let's start with the basics for now. Elk senses are razor sharp. If they see you or hear you, you'll spook them, and they'll bolt. You gotta move slowly and quietly and keep that aside. But an elk's nose is as big as defense. When you're tracking elk, you always need to watch the wind direction. If you don't stay downwind of them, they'll pick up your scent and be gone before you can say boo, especially with that distinctive, musk of yours.
I'm calling pot and kettle on that, my friend.
All right, this is a prime area right here. You feeling ready, Trevor?
Raring to go.
Okay, let's see if we can bag ourselves some elk. I saw a young bull using a down tree to scratch his antlers on not 10 minutes ago. Follow me. I'll keep us downwind so we don't spook him. I love all of God's creatures, right next to the taters and the gravy. Go on, in the head. Trevor, you're colder than a mother-in-law's kiss. All right, stick with me. I'll lead us further in. Keep quiet and stay close. I ain't seen much else or nothing else out here. Oh, we're gonna have to see if we can coax one into the open. That's where that thing you've been chewing on comes in.
Ah, yes. Please enlighten me. It tastes like old person.
That's a diaphragm. Mm-hmm. An elk whistle, you and me. All right, give it a good blow. See if we can get any nearby elk to holler back.
Sounds like someone strangling a clarinet player, and I talk from experience.
Shh, listen. Okay, you hear that? He's over there. You're downwind, so he's yours to lose, Trevor. Go get him. Harp shot, like a true professional. Okay, follow me. We'll move a little further in. Stay quiet. I think we might have a mating pair up ahead. Let's check it out. Now, remember, if it's a pair, we're only here for the male. No does. That's my rule. So if you see one with no antlers, leave it be. Blow your whistle again. See if you can get a beat on him. Okay, this is good. Same as before, nice and steady. Now lay him in the shade. You got this now, Trevor. You're on your own for the next one. Tell you what, I got an idea how we can go in on this together. Text me a pic of your next kill, and we'll talk business. I gotta go. Good luck. I'll holler at you in a while. Got the photo. Another nice kill. So this is what I'm thinking. All this demand for wild-raised meat with them city folks right now? If we divide and conquer, I reckon we could make ourselves a tidy little sideline. Text me a photo of your quarry. I'll let you know what it's worth and come by to pick it up as soon as I can. I like my meat with some age on it anyways. What do you say?
Yeah, I say we'll see. I got a few other irons in the fire at the moment.
All right, well, the offer's there. And you can keep that elk collar. Was my grandma's before she passed. Be hearing from you.
Traveler's checks were in there.
Wait, no,
yeah, I know.
your problem?
Say something else.
I'm ready. Let's go.
It was a mistake.
Come in, come in.
You got what's coming.
Do you know how you want it done? Thanks for stopping by.
Name's, Jimmy Boston. This is quite the
work on that last pickup. The next stop is off Route 13 near some storage barns.
On it. Is it secure?
I don't know. The Aztecas got eyes on everything, man.
I've made the pickup.
Good job. Before they even knew you were there. Watch your back there, Trevor. Other vehicles coming in.
They're coming after me. That chopper seems to have finally given up.
Got some more deliveries for you. Plane is loaded up. Make the drops, man.
Cargo received.
Money in the bank, man.
Another package received.
Muy bien. That's all the drops done. Come on home now.